Hi everyone, in this video we will discuss about AutoCoding feature of NVivo. NVivo allows us to use a variety of automatic coding techniques to speed up the coding process. You can AutoCode based on structure, style, or existing coding patterns. In some cases, when you have structured data or when you use survey with the same open-ended questions, this tool becomes very useful. If we examine interview reports in researchers' data, we can see that these reports have different questions and different number of questions. In other words, the questions and answers are not well structured from one document to others. Thus, AutoCoding will not work in this case because it will result in a messy code structure. In this video, we'll use a different dataset. The interview reports in this dataset have a better structure. They use the same main questions for all participants, so we can perform AutoCoding for this dataset. First, let's look at how to perform AutoCoding using paragraph styles. If you have applied paragraph styles in your documents, you can use them to automatically code the content. You can apply paragraph styles in Word before you import the source, or you can apply them in NVivo. For this example, I use a different dataset in which we have paragraph styles in our documents using headings. Let's look at the interview reports for Thomas. Heading 1 is applied for the main question. Heading 2 is applied for the persons, interviewer or interviewees. And interviewer, this is a style created by the researcher for the specific interview sub-questions, and normal style for the answer. To auto-code this dataset, we select Analyze tab in the ribbon and then choose AutoCode. The AutoCode wizard opens and we need to follow the steps on the wizard. Click Paragraph Styles. From the available paragraph style list, select the styles you want to use for coding and click the right arrow button to add the styles. For example, in this case, we select Heading 1, Main Question, Interviewer, Sub-question, and Normal Answer. A note is automatically created for each paragraph that is formatted in the selected style, and the text under style is auto-coded at the note. The order of the styles in the list determines how they are nested in the note hierarchy. The first style is the parent of the second, and so on. In the next step, select where you want to store the newly created notes. The existing note option is to store the created notes under an existing parent note. In this case, we select New Note to store the created notes under a new parent note. In the name field, we enter the name for the new parent note. Let's call it AutoCode, then click Finish. We can view the created notes by selecting notes on the left panel. You see that a note called AutoCode has been created. AutoCode is a parent note, and we have chai notes as main questions. We also see the sources and references for each note. If we click on each note, for example, Q1, we will see second level chai notes, which are sub-questions and answers to those sub-questions. Other auto-coding options include auto-code by paragraph to make a number note for each paragraph, or auto-code based on existing coding patterns. The former may not be very useful unless the paragraphs in your data are well structured. The latter requires to have existing coding patterns. In summary, auto-coding only is a great tool if you have structured documents and the structure is well designed to match with your research objectives. It helps speed up the process. However, this requires a very careful structure design for the interview or reporting process. In reality, qualitative data are collected for exploratory purposes, and such well-designed structure may not exist. In addition, if researchers want to examine the research problem from a different perspective, the existing structure may not be applicable. In these cases, autocoding may not work and you will need to use the interactive coding method. That is how to perform autocoding using NVivo. Thank you and bye now.